A very common use case for AWS Lambda is dealing with time series data. So in today's video, I thought we'd build a time series application using AWS Lambda and Timescale Cloud. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. My name is Mathis. I'm a developer advocate at Timescale. And today, we'll go over how to write a simple serverless time series application using AWS Lambda and Timescale Cloud. But before we get started, let's get some basics down. AWS Lambda is a compute service that allows you to run code in the cloud without having to worry about the underlying infrastructure. Almost everything is taken care of by AWS, from resource management and the operating system to logging and scaling. The only thing we need to worry about is our application code. Additionally, we'll be using TimescaleDB on Timescale Cloud to store all of our time series data. As with AWS Lambda, we don't have to worry about the underlying infrastructure, configuration, or management, as all of that is taken care of for us by Timescale Cloud. There's currently a 30-day free trial with no credit card required, so you can follow along to this tutorial at no cost. Find out more at cloud.timescale.com or click the link in the description. The application we'll write today isn't very complex, but it serves as a stepping stone into building a bigger and more production-ready application. In later videos, we'll talk about integrating AWS Lambda and TimescaleDB with other AWS services like Kinesis, IoT Core, and Greengrass. If you're interested in seeing those videos, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell down below. So what we're going to build today is a simple API with two routes. One that allows a temperature sensor to push its temperature reading into our TimescaleDB database, and one that allows a user to get the latest temperature reading from all of our sensors. Both these routes will be served by separate Lambda functions written in Python. To make it easier for us, we'll use the AWS SAM CLI. This way, we don't have to worry about provisioning our cloud infrastructure like the API gateway, ECR repositories, and Lambda functions manually, but feel free to use the serverless framework or provision the resources yourself at your own discretion. So let's get started. Because there's a lot of boilerplate configuration when using the SAM CLI, you can git clone the repository link below to follow along with this video. Once you've done that, we can take a look at the anatomy of our project. One of the most important files in our project is the template.yaml file. This file contains a configuration or blueprint for our application. We can see that two functions are defined under the resources record. These have some information about the package type, architecture, and events. The most important part here is the Docker context under metadata. This tells the SAM CLI where the code to our Lambda function is written, which correlates to the two folders in our project called GetSensorData and PostSensorData. Another important one to mention is the API route declaration under events. This tells the SAM CLI how to set up our API gateway. Both of our functions live in the slash sensor path. The only difference is their respective request method, so depending on whether we send a GET or POST request, we'll use a different function. Another very important part of the template.yaml file is the globals record. Here, we've declared an environment variable called constring, which holds a connection string to our Timescale Cloud instance. You can get this connection string from the Timescale Cloud console when you first create your instance, or from the connection info panel in the overview tab of your service. Just don't forget to add your password to the service URL. Do keep in mind that this is not very secure, as anyone with access to the function in the AWS console will be able to see your connection string in the configuration tab. In a real production environment, it might be best to store your database credentials in AWS Secrets Manager and retrieve them using the SDK. But for the sake of time, we'll just use an environment variable. In globals, we also find the VPC config record. Here, we can configure whether or not our Lambda function should be in a VPC and which security groups it should have. This is great if we want our Lambda function to be in a private subnet that is peered to our Timescale Cloud VPC. This way, you run no risk of exposing your valuable time series data to the public internet. If you want to know how to set up VPC peering with Timescale Cloud, watch the video linked in the description below, or click on the card in the top right corner. If you don't want your Lambda functions to be in a VPC, you can comment out those five lines or remove them altogether. Now that we know all about the template.yaml file, let's write some actual code. To start off, we'll write the PostSensorData function that allows us to send a POST request to our API gateway, parse the body of that request, and insert that data into TimescaleDB. It's worth mentioning that this Lambda function is written for demonstration purposes only. And for the sake of simplicity and time, we've omitted some things like authentication, validating inputs, and handling errors properly. If you're looking to write a similar Lambda function for production use, please refer to AWS's best practices guide. First and foremost, let's make a psycopg2 Postgres connection object by reading the contents of the constring environment variable and passing it to the connect function. From that connect function, we will create a cursor object that will allow us to actually execute queries on our database. Next up, we'll write a SQL query that will create a hypertable if it doesn't exist yet. As you can see in the query, the hypertable is called sensorData and contains the time, location, and temperature of a specific reading. Then we execute the query and commit. If you're worried about performance, this is a good time to talk about how AWS Lambda executes code, because unlike what you might think, this statement does not run every time we call our Lambda function. When the Lambda function is called for the very first time, it will execute the Python script as usual, executing this query. This is called a cold start. When the Lambda function is called again, only the Lambda handler function is called. At this stage, the function is warm and will stay warm as long as it's being used. After about 30 minutes of inactivity, our function goes cold again, and the cycle restarts. So in reality, this table creation query will only execute once so long as the function is being used. Technically, you could create this table manually and save off a couple milliseconds of startup time, but I think it's worth demonstrating how Lambda functions behave. Let's move on to the real brains of our Lambda function, the Lambda handler. This function takes an argument called event. The event contains all the information about the request that triggered this Lambda function, and looks something like this. The only thing we need from this event is the body. So let's use the JSON library to marshal this string into a Python dictionary we can use. The request body will look something like this. So we can get the temperature and location fields and assign them to their respective variables. Let's print them out for good measure. Then we will execute an insert query to insert those variables into our database. Take note of how we format those values in our query. Doing it this way will prevent SQL injection attacks. Lastly, we commit our transaction to the database and return a 200 status code to signify all went well. As mentioned previously, we're not doing any proper error handling, but if something were to go wrong, the AWS Lambda runtime is smart enough to return a 500 status code, which is the status code for internal server error. Congratulations, you've written your first Lambda function. Before we can try it out, we need to build our Lambda function. Open a terminal and type sam build. Once this is finished, we can test our function by executing sam local invoke PostSensorData function -e events slash post.json. The file we're passing as an argument is what our API gateway event looks like. Do note that if your Timescale Cloud instance is VPC peered to your AWS VPC, this won't work as the Lambda function is run locally and therefore won't be able to connect your instance. To get around this, you might want to use a local Docker container to host TimescaleDB. If all went well, your TimescaleDB instance should now have a hypertable called SensorData, which should have a single row in it. Great. Let's move on to the next Lambda function. This Lambda function will query our database for the latest 5 sensor readings. The beginning of our function is exactly the same as the previous function, so let's move on to the Lambda handler. Here, we execute a simple SQL query that returns the latest 5 sensor readings ordered by time. We'll create a list variable called response to store them. Then, we gather all the rows from our query by doing cursor.fetchAll. This function returns a list object, so we can just iterate over it. In our iteration loop, we append a dictionary to the response object. The dictionary contains the Unix timestamp, location, and temperature. Lastly, we return a 200 status code and our response variable as a JSON string in the body. Let's build our functions again by doing sam build. After that completes, we can test it out by doing sam local invoke getSensorData function -e events slash getJSON. And it works! Let's deploy our functions and infrastructure to AWS. We can do this very easily by running sam deploy --guided. Behind the scenes, AWS will create a cloud formation stack and create all the required resources. Locally, the SAM CLI will build the Docker containers and push them to the ECR repositories. This is bound to take a while, especially when you deploy your application for the first time, but should be a lot quicker the times thereafter. If everything went according to plan, you should see an output at the bottom of your terminal. The value of your output is your API Gateway endpoint. Alternatively, you can find the endpoint by going to the API Gateway service and selecting the API with the same name as your SAM stack. Once we have the endpoint, we can open up a tool like Postman to make a GET request to retrieve all our temperature measurements, or a POST request with the correct body to insert new measurements. And that's how you create a serverless time series application on AWS Lambda and Timescale Cloud. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to be notified of any future videos about AWS Lambda, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell down below. My name is Mathis, and I'll see you next time.